the Lord, everybody. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good, doeth forever. Hallelujah. It's a good thing to give thanks unto the Lord. We welcome you once again to worship with us, and we're so happy you decided to join the Prince of Peace Baptist Church in St. Louis, Missouri. We're so happy to have you with us. Share some of this with your friends. Get on the phone and call them or text them to let them know that Pop Church is in worship today. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Now, God has a word for us today from Luke, the 15th chapter, the 1st through the 10th verse. It says, "Then all the tax collectors and the sinners drew near to him to hear him. And the Pharisees and scribes complained, saying, 'This man receives sinners and eats with them.' So Jesus spoke this parable to them, saying, 'What man of you having 100 sheep, if he loses one of them, does not leave the 99 in the wilderness and go after the one which is lost until he finds it? And when he has found it, he lays it on his shoulders, rejoicing. And when he comes home, he calls together his friends and neighbors, saying to them, "Rejoice with me, for I have found my sheep which was lost." I say to you that likewise there will be more joy in heaven over one sinner who repents than over 99 just persons who need no repentance. Or what woman having 10 silver coins, if she loses one coin, does not light a lamp, sweep the house, and search carefully until she finds it? And when she has found it, she calls her friends and neighbors together, saying, "Rejoice with me, for I have found the piece which I lost." Likewise, I say to you, there is joy in the presence of the angels of God over one sinner who repents. May the Lord bless the reading of his holy word. Let's bow in a word of prayer. Father God, in the name of Jesus, it's such an honor and a privilege to come before you again and pray on behalf of your people. Lord, we thank you that you not only hear the prayers in this worship service, but you hear our prayers in our homes and at work and wherever we are. And you're such a mighty God that you can hear us all at one time. And for that, we say thank you. We thank you that you hear the whispers of our hearts and you see our tears when they fall onto our pillows. Lord, some are moaning and crying because they have lost loved ones. Some are sick with COVID. Some are sick in the hospital with various diseases. But Lord, you still hear our prayer and you still hear our cry. And for that, we say thank you. Lord, we want to thank you so much for being a forgiving God, for being a God who will hear our repentant cry. For you, Lord God, long for us to come back and be joined with you. Oh, God in heaven, we thank you because you've been so good to us. You've been so patient and kind with us. We rejoice in your blessings. We rejoice in your goodness. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the man who trusts in him. In Jesus' name, we give you praise. Let's say amen as our music ministry comes at this time.
Good morning, Prince of Peace. Good morning, Prince of Peace. Can you do me a favor? Can you type in the comment section that God is great? God is great. God is great. Come on, can you just, come on, just type inside the comment section that God is great, God is great. And since you said that God is great, won't you give him a great praise today? Won't you give him a great praise today? Oh, come on, you said that he was great, so let your praise match his greatness. Let your praise match his greatness. Come on, come on, come on. Just for about 15 more seconds, come on in the comment section. Just begin to praise God wherever you are. You can be inside your living room. You can be inside your bedroom. You can be inside your kitchen cooking. Come on, come on. He moved the mountains that you thought that was not able to move. He broke the chains that you were not able to break by yourself. He got you out of bondage when you should have stayed in there. Give God praise for it. Come on, come on. About 10 more seconds, give God praise. Come on now. Yes, sir.
Worship. worshiping God through giving. Amen. We have three ways that you can give here at the Prince of Peace Church. You can mail it in to 9350 Natural Bridge Road, St. Louis, Missouri, 63134. Or you can go online to princeofpeacechurchstl.com. Or, I've told you my favorite way, through Givelify. Download the Givelify app, and you can give 24 hours a day. While you're getting your tithes, your offerings, your gifts, your first fruit ready, we're going to have our announcements.
Ephesians 2:8 says, "For it is by grace you have been saved through faith, and this is not from yourselves, it is a gift of God. God has graciously allowed us to come together again in 2021. Therefore, Pastor wants you to know that it is imperative that we stay connected to the vine, which is Christ Jesus. We must remain connected so that we can continue to grow in his love and word, so that we may bear much fruit, which lead to eternal life." Pastor would like for us to stay connected during the week. First, we kick off Sunday with our worship service, which is broadcast live via YouTube and Facebook at 10 a.m. We have Sunday school from 8:45 to 9:30 every Sunday morning. If you would like to become part of this Sunday school list, please visit www.princeofpeacechurchstl.com and look for Connect with Us to register. Once your registration is completed, you will be provided the Zoom information. On Monday, we have a conference call, Intercessory Prayer, with Elder Irons L. and the Intercessory Prayer team. To connect to this call, please dial 712-770-5505 and enter code 535-773. On Wednesday at 6 p.m., please join us for Pop Talk via Facebook Live. Throughout the week, we have our small group sessions. To register for a class, visit PrinceofPeaceChurchSTL.com and look for the small group session. We're pleased to announce we have partnered with an organization that is giving out free diapers and women's personal items. If you're interested, please visit PrinceofPeaceChurchSTL.com, go to the COVID-19 corner, and click the link, and complete the form under the Diapers and Personal Care Giveaway section. As we embark upon this new year, 2021, and journey forward to be more mature and healthy disciples, we are asking that this becomes an intentional and strategic approach to bring glory to God. We are all at different ages and stages in life, but the challenge for you today is, what step are you on in this journey, and what is your plan to advance to the next step? We want everyone to stay safe and healthy, so please wear your mask, maintain social distancing of at least 6 feet, and wash your hands for at least 20 seconds.
Amen. Let's lift our offerings before the Lord. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we thank you that once again you've enabled us to give. Father, there may be those who are desiring to have a gift, and we pray, Lord God, that they will trust you for provision, because we know that we cannot beat you giving. You are such a great God, and we thank you for all that you've done. We ask now that you'll receive our gifts in Jesus' name. Amen. Let's say amen for the music ministry.
Power. glory to God, saints. Come on, give glory to God, saints. Come on, give glory to God, saints. Lift those hands, lift those hands. Give glory to God. Thank you. Give him glory, give him glory. Give him glory, give him glory. Give him glory. Give him glory, give him glory. From the rising of the sun until the setting of the same, his name is worthy to be praised. We thank you for one more day. We thank you for one more opportunity. We thank you for breath in our bodies. We did not have to be here, but you kept us from dangers seen, hallelujah, and dangers unseen. And for that, we are so grateful. As we pray together, as we pray together. Father, let your presence be magnified in this place. All across the city of St. Louis, all across the nation, every home that is watching, every car, every bedroom, every living room, kitchen, basement, wherever God's people have gathered, Lord, let your presence be known in that place. We give you our hearts, we give you our thoughts, we give you our lives, Lord. Because you've given us your all. Lord, teach us how to be mature disciples, Lord. We don't want to be the same. Change us, mold us, make us live right, act right, talk right, Lord, in your will, Lord. And thank you, Father, for just putting up with us. Thank you for forgiving us. Thank you for looking past our faults and meeting every one of our needs. Now, Father, I pray, God, that you would give me the strength, give me the anointing to preach your word today, to say what you would have me to say to your people. And God, I pray that we just won't hear this word, but God will start doing the word. We praise you and we thank you, Lord. And before we end this prayer, God, don't forget about my neighbor, Lord. Bless the people that lived on my left and on my right, my neighbor, my children, my family, God, all across the country, Lord. Send your blessings, Lord. And God, we're not selfish with our shout. We will shout over the fact that you are blessing somebody else other than us. We will rejoice because you're being good to our families and our friends and our acquaintances and our neighbors. You are wonderful. You are wonderful. You are wonderful. We give you glory. We give you honor. Thank you, Lord. Honor unto. Amen. 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 Praise the name of God. Praise the name of God. I welcome all of you all to our Sunday morning worship. What a blessing it is to be in the house of God, and what a blessing it is to be in your living room, your car, on your job, wherever you are, and you are tuning in to this worship experience. We're just so glad that you are a part. Thanks to Minister Kathy Gamble. She is one of God's best women of God, and just thank her so much. She sacrifices to be here and to help in our worship experience. Thank you so much. Thank you to the best band in the land, Brother Marcus, LaFolia, and Jason, and Minister Joseph Price. So grateful for them, and Robin Greenlee, and all our camera people. Brother Tim in our sound room, Sister LaChasha in the back, and the best young adult choir in the city of St. Louis. Amen. I thank God for Donovan. He's just growing in the Lord, and we're just so excited about his growth in the Lord. Amen. If you would turn in your Bibles to Luke chapter 15, Luke chapter 15, there is a word from the Lord our God. So please, people of God, we're nearing the end of our fast. How many of you all have been fasting this month with us? How many of you all have been fasting? There are people raising their hand in the sanctuary. Raise your hand online. Say, I'm fasting with you. Pastor, I'm fasting with you, and I'm fasting with you. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. Whatever the Lord has laid on your heart. And if you started late with the fast, then I need you to go into February. Go into February with your fast. And then we're also giving our first fruits this month. We're giving our first fruits. We're telling God, first of all, we love you. And then we believe, we have faith that when we place a seed in good ground, we know that God is going to bring us a great harvest. Amen. I am excited about this word. I'm going to start a series this Sunday. I don't know when it's going to end. It's going to end when the Lord tells me it's going to end. But I'm going to start a series on the theme of shift. S-H-I-F-T, shift. Somebody say shift. Shift, shift, shift. I wonder if you got a little Holy Ghost in you when I say the word shift. Because Minister Gamble, shift by definition means a change in direction. By definition, it means a change in position or a change in place. That ought to shout you better than you've been shouting. Because if your money is funny, God says a shift is about to happen. Yeah. If you're at a place that you don't want to be in, and you believe that there's a greater place you can be in, God said a shift is about to happen. I just dare you for 10 seconds, just like Donovan said, just thank God for the shift that's coming. Thank God for the shift that's coming. Glory, glory, glory to God. Somebody declare, Satan, you will not win. We're going to recover all. We're going to recover all because a shift is coming. He's not going to strangle and hold to our families. He's not going to keep us bound. He's not going to keep our children chained because a shift is coming. Oh, my God. Yes, God. Somebody shout real three times real loud. A shift. A shift. A shift. A shift. My money is shifting. My mind is shifting. My life is shifting. My children are shifting. Glory to God. Yes, yes. Good God about it. Woo. Good God about it. Good God about it. Yes. Good God about it. Good God about it. Miracles. Signs, wonders are over me. Because a shift is coming. A shift is coming, Carlton. A shift is coming. Miracles, signs, wonders are over me. Miracles, signs, wonders are over me. Because a shift is coming. Yeah. Yeah. Let's get to this text. 15. Mm. somebody shout, I feel a shift coming. Oh. I feel a shift coming. Yeah. So we're gonna deal with shift for a few weeks. We're gonna deal with shift for a few weeks. Some things about to happen. Some things gonna about to happen. Some things. When you go back to the doctors, a shift is gonna happen. Yeah. A shift is gonna happen. Let's read this. This very, very familiar text. I learned this story in Sunday school about the prodigal son. Luke 15 and 11. And then he said, a certain man had two sons. The younger of them said to his father, Father, give me the portion of goods that falls to me. So he divided to them his livelihood, and not many days after, the younger son gathered all together, journeyed to a far country, and there wasted his possessions with prodigal living. And when he spent all that he had, there arose a severe famine in the land, that he began to be in want. And then he went and joined himself to a citizen of that country, and he sent him into his fields to feed swine. Listen. And he would have gladly filled his stomach with the pods that the swine ate, because no one gave him anything. Watch the shift. But when he came to himself, I love the word of God. Oh, when he came to himself, he said, how many of my father's hired servants have bread enough and to spare, and I perish with hunger? I will arise and go to my father's house, and I'll say to him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and before you, and I'm no longer worthy to be called your son. Make me like one of your hired servants. And he arose and he came to his father. But when he was still a great way far away, his father saw him, had compassion, ran and fell on his neck and kissed him. And the son said to him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and in your sight, and no longer worthy to be called your son. But the father said to his servants, bring out the best robe, put it on him, put a ring on his hand, sandals on his feet, and bring the fatted calf and kill it, and let us eat and be merry. Repeat after me real loud. Say, Pastor, need all your prayers and all your amens. He's going to preach from this subject. You need to own your own shift. You need to learn to own your own shift. The great theologian David Trueblood said these words. He said that we live in a cut flower civilization. That got me to thinking when he said we live in a cut flower civilization. All you sisters, come real quick. Got a cut flower for you. Come on all the way up here. Come on. I wanna see if you've been at church today, you would have been blessed with a beautiful flower. There you go. David Trueblood said, we live in a cut flower civilization. Isn't that beautiful? Isn't that beautiful? Is that pretty? Oh my. I think sisters like getting roses. Y'all like that? Oh, when I want to show you expressions of love. Come on, daughter. I got enough for you. Oh, look at that. Isn't that pretty? Look at it. Isn't it pretty? Amen. Now, when you get back to your seat, I want you to smell it because it's just not pretty. It looks good. Hey, Danielle. Oh, I'm going to bless you with a rose because you a rose. Look at that. Look at you. They're even good for the young folk. And so since you're so special, you get two roses. And let me get one for myself because there are some men who like roses too. Ah, look at it. Isn't it beautiful? Put your rose up there. Isn't it smells good? Doesn't it look good? And as good as it looks, and it's as nice as it smells, it's got death all over it. Smells good. Looks good. But there's an expiration date all over it. You know why? Because it's been cut from its source. Preach, Pastor. You give it a week, you give it 2 weeks, you give it 3 weeks, and it's heading to the trash. How could something so beautiful and smell so good today be headed for the trash can? Because it's been cut from its source. David Trueblood said, we live in a cut flower society. No wonder so many relationships are so trashy. Could it be that because it's been cut from the source? No wonder so many families, we used to have close families, family with unions, loving families. No wonder our families are so trashy. Parents trying to be friends with their children. Because when you raise children right, there will be times they do not like you. No wonder we have such trash in our present generation. Gangster rap has taken our people to the trash. Because gangster rap theme is all about women and money. And they treat our women like trash because they've been cut from the source. And they soon discover that there are things money cannot buy you. Robert Williams, when he died, had $100 million in the bank. He killed himself because he was proving that money could not buy you health. And if you're not careful, you might look good today. And you might think you might smell good today. But if you are cut off from the source, you are dead man or dead sister walking. Preach, Kilpatrick, I'm doing the very best that I can. In Luke chapter 15, this father has two sons. The young son says, give me my inheritance. He takes his inheritance. He goes to the far country. And the next thing you know, he was living in the trash. How does he go from a life of prosperity into the trash can of life? Because he was cut off from the source. My God, Lord, when we look at our communities, there's all trash in it. When we look at relationships, it's all trash in it. When we watch the news, we see all trash in it. God, how can we reconnect with you? Because you are the only hope for a hopeless world. And if you are not in the trash, you know somebody that who is. And how do you help someone come out of the trash? How do you help someone connect back to God? I'm glad you asked that question. I'm glad you asked. Because the text is tailored to teach us how to stay out of the trash, how to get out of the trash. Oh my God. What does this young son of this father do? What did he do? He owned his own shift. Bless God. How did he own it? First of all, people of God, he woke up. If you gonna own your shift, you gotta wake up. The text says, thank you, God. The text says, and he came to himself. Eric Badu was one of the first persons I ever heard about, you know, talking about you need to be woke. You need to be woke. That's our problem, is that we sleep. We need to be woke. And now it's become a hood euphemism for being awake to racism. But I would like to add an argument that racism is not our biggest problem. White folk is not our biggest issue. The biggest issue in the black community ain't what racist people are doing, is what we are doing. Because the truth is, y'all, the 264 people that were murdered in St. Louis in 2020, white folk didn't do that. Black folk did that. And listen, if black lives are to matter, then black lives need to matter to black people. Listen. When it comes to African American and community, we have the highest dropout rate for high school students. White folk didn't do that. We did that. Bad parenting did that. You buying Jordans for your kids, you buying PlayStation 10, well, it's only on 6. Well, black folk gonna be buying PlayStation 10 if they could. While your child is flunking out of school, your kid can't even read. White folk didn't do that. White folk didn't come on your block and steal the tags off your car. White folk didn't do that. Black people did that. And until we wake up in our own community, because I'm going to tell you something, God has blessed me. White folk ain't never stopped me from doing anything. I don't have a problem with you know, if you're going to be racist, that's between you and God. Because I'm going to tell you one thing. If God be for you, no one, no man, no racist can stop God from doing what he's going to do in your life. So instead of waiting on the government to do for you, instead of waiting for other people or what nobody else did for you, you got to wake up yourself and say, I got to take ownership of my own shift. Because what happens is, if you don't take ownership of your shift, you will become comfortable in uncomfortable places. He is in a hog's pen. He is in a pig's pen. That is not his destiny. That is not what God made him for. But when you are asleep, you will put up with dysfunctional places. I know y'all don't want to say amen, but there are people who claim they love God and they'll get in dysfunctional places and they'll stay there and be comfortable in places God never meant for them to be in. You go to sleep. How you a sister? How you the sister of Harriet Tubman? How you the sister of Barbara Jordan? How you the daughter of these great women? And you can be in a relationship with somebody going upside your head. How? I need one sister in here to say, you only got one time, put your hands on me. But I'm just amazed of how many times people get comfortable in places that's supposed to be uncomfortable for you. How the enemy can lull you to sleep and make you put up with trash. Oh my God, oh my God. I remember Roots. When Roots first came out, one of my favorite movies, I love me some Kunta Kinte. I loved them at the beginning of the movie, but as it progressed, I kind of lost a little energy for them. Why would you do that? Because if you remember at the beginning of the movie, he said, my name is Kunta Kinte. That was his roots. That's where he came from. That's who he was. It spoke. His name spoke honor. His name spoke identity. My name is Kunta Kinte. They hit him. And they said, your name is Toby. He said, my name is Kunta. I said, stand up, man. Stand up for who you are. Stand up for what you believe. And they whipped him again. What is your name, boy? My name is Kunta Kinte. He ran away, and they beat him again. They beat him, and then they cut off his foot. And they said, what is your name? My name is Toby. He was on a wagon going to town. He was on a wagon. He wasn't calling himself Kunta Kinte. He passed up a barn. He heard some drums in a barn, and he went in, remember, and he saw some men from the motherland, and he started remembering from whence he came, and then he realized his mistake. He had normalized his nightmare when he said, my name is Toby. When the enemy gets in your spirit, he will make you normalize a nightmare. And you will become comfortable in places that God never ever meant for you to be. I know it's hard to say hallelujah when you're getting your foot stepped on. But anybody ever accepted something that was beneath you? And you knew that that was not what God had for you? I was amazed. I was shocked. I was amazed. I was amazed. That what November the 6th when the election, I discovered, I was amazed. One out of five black college men voted for Trump. I was shocked. I was shocked, you all, that 6% of the black vote. He rose in the African American community. He went up 6% in the vote. I was like, do you all forget that he has been the most racially tense president that we ever had? Did you all forget about Charlottesville? Do you all forget about what he did to Barack Obama and birthism? They said he didn't even come from America. Do you remember all of the racist things that he has done? How he cascaded people who had disabilities? Did you all forget? But you normalize a nightmare. And whatever the enemy gets into you and makes you normalize things that are not normal, a selfish spirit will rise up on you. I'm preaching good. I don't care what y'all say. Look how selfish he is. Give me, Donovan. He says, give me my inheritance. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. You from my generation, Minister Gamble? You from my generation? Wait a minute. I could be wrong. Correct me. Come up on this stage and correct me if I'm wrong. Aren't you supposed to get your inheritance when I'm dead? But when you are selfish, oh my God, when you don't think about other people, you only think about yourself. Did you think about how your choices affected this family? Did you think about what you did, how it affected your father? That your father is sitting in his window every night looking for you. How his heart is broken. But when a selfish spirit comes over your mind, you don't care about other people. And that's what the devil's trying to do to church. He's trying to make us selfish. People of God, when you live by yourself or for yourself, you're going to get corrupted by your own company. Ooh, you just said something. That's so good, I got to say it two times. When you live by yourself, when you live for yourself, you are going to be corrupted by your own company. It even happens in this worship experience. Everyone that is watching me right now, somebody else ought to be watching it with you because of you. You ought not be selfish in your worship, because it is in worship that God begins to heal all of us. And you ought not be so selfish that the only healing you want to happen is the healing for your house. Matter of fact, when you really know God for yourself, you want everybody that you know to get some healing too. That's why you ought to invite somebody to worship. You ought to invite somebody to worship. Somebody ought to be in here for worship. You ought to get somebody in worship, because in worship, the presence of God shows up. When we began to praise God, God's presence began to invade the sanctuary. I need some people that know how to invite the presence of God. That means I am not selfish. That it means I'm not concerned about myself. I'm thinking about the great God who is able to do anything but fail. Because when praises go up, blessings began to come down. And when they come down, I don't just want it coming down on my house. I want it to come down on your house, and your house. Now, if you're selfish in your praise, keep your seat. But if you're not selfish in your praise, get on your feet and begin to thank God, because you want the blessings to come down on that house, on that house, on that house, and your house in the name of Jesus. Yeah. Everybody needs to be in church. Everybody needs to be in church. There's something that's special. There's something special that God does when we come to church together. Now let me cut to the chase. Let me cut something off at its knees. Because people getting this attitude like, oh, I could be at the church by myself. No, you can't. I know it sounds good and people have been saying it, but no, you can't. That's just like a football player talking about, I'm the football team. No, you not. You might be able to play, but you got to show up at the field with the other players to play the football game. You may, the Lord, you, and we get that, we said the our bodies are the temple of the Lord. Yeah, it's the temple, but it ain't the church. The church is the body of Christ. The church is us. It's when we come together, there's some power in the room. See, when the church comes together, sometimes the enemy wants to cut you off so you'll be by yourself. And while you're by yourself, that's how a lion destroys the sheep. That's how the wildebeest, he cuts them off from the flock. That's why he wants you to be cut off. But God wants us to be together because we got strength together. Because I don't know what you're going through, but my praise might help you. My shout might encourage you. my hallelujah might speak a word to you. So I can't keep it to myself. I come in the church and God begins to bless all of us. I'm gonna say some controversy, and you can email me whatever. But you can't have God without the church. And the church is us's. You cannot have God. Oh, yes, I can. No, you can't. You are out of line with scripture. When God says he's coming back, he didn't say, I'm coming back for an individual. I'm coming back for the church. He's coming back for us's. We keep trying to have God without the church. That's like dating a sister who has children. And she fine. She real fine. And then you meet her kids. And you say, I want you, baby. But them kids got to go with their daddy. Now, a real sister going to say, if you going to get me, you get me and all 11 of these kids. Shaniqua, Transhika, Larry. You get them all. If you want God, you got to get the church. The church presents God. You got to wake up. We got to wake up. But not only we got to wake up. If you going to own your shift, not only you got to wake up. Number two, you got to get up. First, the text says, he came to himself. Then the text says, I think that's verse 16. Then the text says, maybe verse 17. He says, then the text says, he arose. He arose after he had hit rock bottom. And let me tell you something. When he hit rock bottom, he discovered that Jesus was the rock at the bottom. Now, y'all, I got to go on with this sermon because I don't have a lot of time. The beans are cooking on the oven. The greens are starting to boil. So I got to hurry up and get through this and move on. But I need about 10 people who are not shy, who are not ashamed, and who are not going to hide their testimony. I know it's hard sometimes to be honest, but I really need you to be honest. I need people who know what it feels like to be on the bottom. But after being on the bottom, the reason why you on the top is because Jesus reached way down and came and got you. I used to be on the bottom, but God brought me out. Thank you, God, that you came and got me in the nick of time. He had lost his funds, his friends, his family, his food, and now he's in a famine. Oh my God, look at that. Food, funds, family, friends, now he's in a famine. Listen to Pastor Whale. He had wasted his funds. The enemy is trying to get you to waste your blessing. He is trying to trick you to make you waste what God has given to you. And there's nothing worse for you to hook up with somebody for 2 years, 5 years, 10 years, 15 years, and then wake up and discover that you were dating their representative. And then they have wasted 15 years of your life. That's why the Bible says don't be yoked with people you're not equal to. You cannot hook up with people because they smell good and look good. Because if they're cut off from the source, it's going to kill your time. The enemy is trying to waste your life. The enemy is trying to waste your blessing. The enemy is trying to waste what God is trying to do to you or do for you. He wasted it. And after he wasted it, and he gets into your emotions, and you in the field, and you with the pigs, and you're with the hogs. Now he's trying to get you to the next F. You lost your funds, you lost your food, you lost your friends, you lost your family, you're in a famine. Now he's trying to get you to act foolish. Praise Kilpatrick, I'm doing the best that I can. When he gets you, because you used to be with the Father, you used to be in order. But when you get out of order, he wants you to keep making bad decisions so that foolishness destroys everything that you're in. You got to be careful. You got to be careful. You got to own your own ship, because when you get down in the famine and no food, and you start getting foolish, then you start blaming people for your own foolishness. Ooh. Instead of taking personal responsibility for where you are, you start blaming your daddy. My daddy was a drunk. My daddy wasn't there. What does that have to do with the anointing over your life? My mama wasn't there. You ain't the first person that had some parents that were crazy. You are not the first person that went through some issues. And if God brought me out, if God brought somebody else out, God can bring you out too. You got to be careful that you don't allow the enemy to destroy what God is trying to do in your life. I don't know if y'all were, if y'all remember, this is what I did in my life. I said, Lord, teach me to walk in wisdom. Teach me how to take responsibility for myself. Although my mother died when I was 10, my father died when I was 18, alcoholic, never did anything. I asked the Lord, give me wisdom. I was at bottom. I said, Lord, give me wisdom that even when life, and even although you were connected to the Father, doesn't mean that you're not going to go to the bottom. You're going to go to the bottom. Even if you love God, you will go to the bottom. I said, but Lord, give me wisdom, first of all, that if I'm in a hole, stop digging. And then two, Lord, give me the strength to rise up from where I am. Now, I don't know if y'all remember, I used to like horror movies. Now, at 53, I do not like horror movies. The last movie that I saw, I kind of liked it, was Jason versus Freddy. And they had bets in Vegas over who would win, Jason or Freddy. Some folk voted for Freddy. Some folk voted for Jason. I put my money on Jason. Now, Freddy was bad with them knives and things. Freddy was bad. He get in your dreams, scare you half to death. He was bad, but I put my money on Jason. You know why I put my money on Jason? Because if you stab him, he'd come back. They shot him, he would come back. They drowned him in the river. Next thing you know, he came back. I need somebody in here that knows what it feels like to be down, but God gave you the power to come on back. Yeah, you got to own your own shift. You got to, number one, you got to wake up, you got to get up, and then number three, here's the last thing, here's the last thought. You got to think up. Watch what he says in the text. He came to himself. Then he arose. Then he said, at my father's house, he said, they eating potatoes and macaroni and cheese, and they eating roast beef and homemade biscuits and Kool-Aid, red Kool-Aid at my father's house. He said, if I could just go home, I can also eat. I'll just be a servant like everybody else, but I can have some mac and cheese and some dressing and some red Kool-Aid. So you got to have, listen, in the middle of your degradation, you got to keep your imagination. You got to keep thinking in spite of where you are. The Bible says that Paul said in the New Testament, I think myself happy. Y'all ain't happy. Y'all ain't happy. Y'all don't happy because you don't know the context in which Paul said, I think myself happy. When he said it, he was in jail. He was chained. He was a prisoner of Rome. But in the middle of his imprisoned state, Paul said, I think myself happy. Every now and then when you are down, you don't think about being down. You think about things being better. I need somebody in here that knows what it means to think better. I need somebody in here that say, I believe my money is getting better. I believe my family is getting better. I believe my life is getting better. The Bible says that he started to go home. When he got home, the father put a robe and a ring on his body. I came to tell somebody, the best is yet to come. You got to start believing God for the better. You got to start believing God for your miracle. You got to start believing God for signs and wonders. You got to start believing that God is getting ready to open doors you did not knock on. That God's gonna make a way out of no way. And the Bible says that when they got home and the father saw the son, it was like the electric company. If you ever had your water cut off and you see the water people coming to reconnect your water, you say, thank you, Jesus. If you ever been disconnected and God reconnects you, somebody ought to say thank you. If God brought you out, if God brought you out, if God brought you over, if God brought you through, somebody ought to say thank you. If God reconnected your life, somebody ought to say thank you. I got a song that the angels can't sing. I got a praise that the angels can't praise. What is your song? God is the joy and the strength of my life. He moves all pain, misery, and strife. He promised to keep me, never to leave me. He'll never fall short of his word. I gotta fast and pray. Stay in the narrow way. Keep my life clean. Every day I want to go with him. When he comes back, he's come too far and I can't turn back. God is the source of my strength. God is the strength of my life. I lift my hands in total praise. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. You got to own your shift. 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 How do you own your shift? You got to wake up. 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 Come on, come on, come on, come on. You got to wake up. wake up. You got to get up. Come on, come on. You got to get up. Come, come here, come here. Listen to me. You got to think up. You got to think up. Somebody needs to reconnect to God. Somebody got to reconnect to God. How do I reconnect to Him? Wake up. Get up. Think up. God is the joy. He's your all. He's your all in your all. We're going to pray, and while we're praying, I want you to just begin to pray about that. Thank you, Lord. Pray about God connecting you. God is the joy and the strength of my life. Thank you. We're speaking into your life today. Wake up. The kingdom of Satan is real. He's trying to bring you to a trashy place. Today, who's been disconnected, who's never been connected, I pray, God, they wake up today. Every kingdom that is not like you, any kingdom that we're in, if we're not in the kingdom of God, death is all around it. So, Father, bring someone in the kingdom. Bring someone in the kingdom by saying, Lord, I'm sorry. Lord, forgive me. Somebody needs to reconnect. Someone that was disconnected from the church. You cannot be connected to God and be disconnected from his church. When I'm not in the building, that's all right. You're worshiping with others on this broadcast. Time for you to unite with the church. Time for you to unite with the church. Say, Lord, I'm sorry. Lord, forgive me. And if you're here, if you're listening to my voice, or you're disconnected from the church, go to princeofpeacechurch.com and say, I want to become a part of the Prince of Peace Church family. And then we'll connect with you and help you on your journey. Because God is your strength. Thank you, Lord. I live. Thank you. I live my. Thank you, Lord. You are. God is the strength. God is. God is. He's my all. God bless you. God bless you. We were honored by your presence. Listen, next Sunday, make sure that somebody's in worship because of you. Bring someone to worship. And so if I ask you, who is in worship because of you? You ought to be saying, Susie came to worship because of me. Angela came to worship. David came to worship to me. I'll see you on Wednesday night. Make sure that you're growing into a mature disciple. That's what mature disciples do. They bring people into worship. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord keep you. May the Lord's face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May he lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace and give you peace and give you peace until Wednesday night. God bless you.